All right, welcome to round one. This is a perfect hand. This is the hand I was hoping to get with this deck. It's just my mana is pretty bad. Luckily, the cards themselves are like relatively easy to cast, and I got a lot of black cards. Dreadbore, of course, is really difficult, but you know what I mean. I can get red or blue, so I'm going to basically intend on getting red, but I'm just going to wait as long as I can to see if I draw red or blue, and then I'll get the other one with Scalding Tarn. I'll have to decide whether or not playing Desperate Ravings on turn two is a good idea. We'll kind of get there, we'll cross the bridge when we come to it. I'm going to play Overgrown Tomb first, I believe. If he has Wasteland, this is worse, but if I want to discard Godless Shrine, it's better. Alright, so didn't draw blue. I'm going to go with the red here. Spellskite doesn't actually have any real issue yet, but it would prevent me from killing another creature, and it would cost me more mana to kind of get involved. I think it's just better all around to just get it out of the way, because I have two removal spells in my hand. I could wait until I have Rolling Earth 3 for 4, but, you know, why wait? Grab a Snickers. I'm going to go with the Terminate, even though it's an instant. I'm going to do it while he's tapped out, and this way I can deal with a Jace Beleriand or a Elspeth or whatever. Alright, so Rolling Earthquake is showing just how good it actually is. Gamble might prove very interesting if I'm able to get the combination of cards I need. If I gamble for Crucible of the Worlds next turn, that could be pretty sweet. So, I'm going to wait till he flashes it back. I'm going to take a lot of damage and cast Phyrexian Rager. That gets me some presence on the board, and it prevents me from having to cast a card like Desperate Ravings, and now I have enough mana for Fact or Fiction, which is amazing, so that's great. Lingering Souls, no black source just yet. I'm going pretty low, but it looks like his deck, if it is aggressive, it's not that aggressive. Okay, first things first, I'll attack and see what the turn brings. Maybe he has like a Restoration Angel or something. Nope, doesn't have it. And I can play Gamble into Crucible of the Worlds. I'd rather just play Fact or Fiction. I don't think there's any reason to blow anything yet. Why not wait? You know, these random effects, I don't need to cast them yet, so kind of wait until I need to, and then, you know, when I need to get lucky, I will. But no reason to kind of put myself in a position to get lucky. To be fair, I'm not discarding anything relevant, though. So he's played a land every turn. He's mulliganed to, I think, 6 or 5. He's mulliganed to 6. Okay, so he's on the play. He could be that he doesn't have very much in his hand. If he has, like, 2 counter spells, I can beat that. What I'm worried about is some, like, amazing 6 drop. Fact Fiction is so weird in this deck. I can imagine so many splits where it's not that great. Okay, Miscalc comes down. All right. 2 cards left in his hand. I have 5, and I have a bunch of card advantage working. So I'm going to go with Rolling Earthquake later. I'm still not going to cast it. I'm not low on life. He doesn't have any creatures in play. There's no reason for me to really feel all that worried. I'm just going to just bash right into him. So I'm just going to cast Desperate Ravings and flashback Desperate Ravings, I think. So tap these two, cast it. I don't really think I want to play Gladiator. I would rather cycle it. Okay, wow, Crucible's amazing. I want to play it now because I don't want it to get countered, and I don't think he F6'd the original ability. In addition, I don't want to flashback Desperate Ravings and have it hit Crucible. Okay, so there's Sunken Ruins, which will allow him to flashback Lingering Souls, which I hope he does, and then Rolling Earthquake can take it out. Looks like he has a 6 drop of some sort, which Dreadbore should be able to take care of. I hope it does. I hope it's not something like Sun Titan. That'd be devastating. Kaiga. I don't think I care about that too much. So let's plan this out. I can attack to see if he blocks. Then I can Dreadbore. He'll steal the tapped Rager or nothing. Then I can Thoughtseize and Rolling Earthquake after he splashes it back next turn. So let's do that. Okay, so he didn't block. That's a good no block there. I can play Scalding Tarn any old time. Thoughtseizing my opponent. He could have a land in hand. I wouldn't even hit it, but it's just too good not to. Going to 8 is relevant. Maybe I can just wait for the Thoughtseize until I need to resolve something, actually. Casting Dreadbore and not having an answer to a big threat is a pretty big problem, I think. I think it's worth it to cast it. Now I just gotta decide what the rest of my turn is gonna look like. I can gamble for Strip Mine afterwards and Strip Mine the Sunken Ruins or White Source or whatever I want, really, and start stripping away. That, I think, is the right approach. So let's do that. So he has Disfigure. Not really all that great. So then I will Dreadbore Kyaga. Followed by playing Scalding Tarn and passing. Not searching for land because I don't want to take the damage. Then I'll untap. And he'll flashback Lingering Souls, all Rolling Earthquake, gamble for Strip Mine, and start stripping away. The other option, of course, is to gamble for something like Barrel Rites, which I don't have. Man, I didn't play Barrel Rites. I could also Earthquake for 2 here, but then he has the 2 tokens. Yeah, I'd rather just get him. I go really low, of course. I go to 4. And then to 2, and then to 1 off the Scalding Tarn. But I still think it's worth it. Like, I don't think he has any direct removal spells. It would take a lot of balls for him not to flashback Lingering Souls, but if he doesn't actually flashback Lingering Souls, I'm in a little bit of trouble. Oh, but I can strip I can strip it, so it wouldn't matter. Okay, so if he doesn't flashback the Lingering Souls, I do the same play, but then I strip the Sunken Ruins. Interesting. So he did cast it, which is what I wanted to have happen. Scalding Tarn doesn't need to do anything just yet. I'll just leave it where it is. He plays Relic of Progenitus. Man, does it get any worse? Man. Ugh, that is devastating. At least I can gamble and play Strip Mine and then take it from there. But that is just, oh, that's devastating. Well, that was a good draw. I will tap like this and play Rolling with Crate for 2. You know what? I'm just going to play Undead Gladiator this turn. I could Necromancy the Kyaga, but I'd rather just do that later. If I play Undead Gladiator this turn, going to 1, then I can untap and have Necromancy for anything I want. I can also... but he has Relic of Progenitus. So, okay, I see what's going on here. If I Necromancy, heal Relic of Progenitus, removing... Oh, but he targets himself. Okay, it doesn't work. So he doesn't even have to sack the Relic to do that. Well, all right, I'll do it this way. So for 2. And then play Undead Gladiator. Man, Necromancy's a lot worse when he's got Relic out, but at least I can kind of force the issue with Gamble. Or if I draw a creature of my own, I can play Necromancy. He'll use... Oh, here it is. He used it. Oh, because I think he's trying to... Yeah, he's trying to find something to counter it, but he didn't do it. Okay, so Now, I didn't know that would happen. I should sack this. I don't even think I have a mountain in my deck. Yeah, I don't. So that's too bad. I'll just have to cast Gamble next turn. Oh, I could have played the I could have played the Scalding Tarn, but oh well. So I'm gonna gamble here. And what am I? I'm actually gonna gamble for Frost Titan. There's no real reason not to. If I discard it, I can Necromancy it. Oh wait, no, how about Glenlander Archmage? That's probably better. I don't think like Strickland's good. I don't know. Oh man, this is so tough. Getting a creature allows me to have Necromancy turn on. Like, there's a lot of creatures but that Strip Mine doesn't deal with. But Frost Titan would. But Frost Titan is susceptible to Wrathagub, which he's almost certainly playing. But then I can get it back with a get back onto Gladiator. He would have to actually have the Wrathagub. If I get Glenlandra, then he could just draw a big creature and then I'm stuck again. So I'm gonna go with Frost Titan. So discard the swamp, that's fine. Play the swamp. It's actually perfect. Jeez. So I think having access to double black is the culprit here. So things are looking up. So here comes the Day of Judgment. But then I have, man, that discard on gamble was really sweet. That was a hell of a gamble. Okay, so he just was pump faking me. Main deck Relic is a little bit concerning. That makes me want to play a card like Krozen Grip, which is sweet against that kind of card. Powder Keg is also interesting. It deals with Lingering Souls tokens and Relic, but oh, I don't know. It's not like I need it that bad. And my deck isn't actually super reliant on the graveyard. If I cast one of these spells, he has to use it, and then it's all free reign. You know, it's not like I'm playing a bunch of uncastable creatures. Maelstrom Pulse is interesting both against Relic and against these tokens, but I'm delving dangerously into green and I have to support green with something like Summit Growth Chamber and, you know, a bunch of other stuff. So none of these blue cards I want to cut, they were great. Greater Gargonon's also going to be awesome. I think that Terminate or Deadbore should be cut. Fire Spout was interesting, but I already have Rolling Earthquake. So, I think that maybe I don't need this. I don't know what kind of deck he's playing necessarily. I don't think he's playing a bunch of tokens, maybe just Lingering Souls. Gotta cut something, so here we are. I have the one Overgrown Tomb and the Savage Lands, and the two fetches that get Overgrown Tomb. I guess one fetch that gets Overgrown Tomb, and now the Simic Growth Chamber, which cuts Island. I think that's enough to support one Krozen Grip, and that's the only actual green card. None of these other cards really excite me all that much. I'm not a huge fan of Studded Growth. People have really liked that card in the past. I'm not a huge fan. Deep Analysis and Tuca Vigilante, both excellent options as well. I'm not sure where I want to land on that. I think Desperate Ravings and Deep Analysis are similar in a lot of ways, but being cheaper and being able to find lands is really important to me. Rager, drawing a land, probably not as relevant as Deep Analysis getting in there, but then yeah, okay, I do think Deep Analysis is probably better than Rager, but that's pretty close. Gambling for Deep Analysis is a huge game. Okay, so here I go.